Another episode of Two Alphas Talk. So today's episode, what we're going to talk about is training. All right. Training is not going to the range and just shooting at stationary targets. That's called practice. Training is actually going out, taking a professional class with a professional instructor and learning something that's just going to enhance your skills. Basically, you can go out and learn something that was going to teach you distance shooting, movement shooting. You can learn how to defend your home. You can learn how to shoot out of a car. You can learn how to draw better from a concealed carry purpose. Training has a lot of different techniques and a lot of different ways an individual can learn, but you have to go seek that training out. It's not something that comes naturally. You can just watch a video and say, okay, I'm gonna go out and train.
Mm-hmm. And the training coming from an instructor, that instructor does not necessarily have to have been in a gunfight, doesn't necessarily have to have been a military person that's been in war. It has to be somebody who studied what you're taking, what the course curriculum, the information, the topics are. You have to go to someone that knows that information, that maybe when the way he says it the first time, you may not understand it, but yet he can turn it around and still get the same information, but saying it in a different way. Those are the people that you want to see. When you train, you go to a training course, there may be five topics that are there. If you get one thing out of that training, that's worth your money. If one thing that you didn't know prior to coming to that training, that's worth your money. The second thing is you need, and you speak to trainers, a way to take that training from the location that you trained to your home range, whether it's an indoor range or outdoor facility or in your backyard, it doesn't matter. You need to be able to transfer that information that you learn to a practice setting so that you can continue to build on your skill set. And that is somebody who you can find easily if you do a little bit of research.
And also, the training needs to be conducted with the weapons that you're going to primarily use, or the weapons that you're going to master. So the weapons that you can use is, maybe you only carry a concealed carry or a pistol. If that's it, you need to seek out instructors for that. You need to train for that. You need to train for that environment that you think you're going to be using that weapon for. If it's a rifle, if it's a shotgun, you need to seek out those instructors for those rifles and shotguns, because there's classes that's designed just for those too. You can use a rifle and a shotgun just like a pistol if you know how to use it. So you have to, and you have to continue educate and continue to do training. So let's say if I take a basic class on pistol, if I progress, I need to push myself to go to an intermediate. Then if I try to push myself to go to an advanced, this is all for concealed carry purposes. You can't utilize a shooting sport as training because it's actually not training. It will help you hone your skills and get used to your firearm in a certain different way, but it's actually not a training purposes to help you in a gunfight.
Yeah, I concur with that. I totally agree. But it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun, and what you should do is incorporate that fun with some training, because when you do take part in a competition, the timer is one thing. And once you get your understanding of that game in particular, then you can compete with other people. And that competition of trying to do better and faster and more accurate than the next guy is as close that you can simulate doing it in real life. And we all hope that we never get involved into a gunfight, never have to attempt or even take someone else's life. But those things do happen. And in this day and time, it's even more possibilities out there for each and every person that carries a gun.
Right. So the only thing we're saying, if you're going to train, really put the time in.
Spend the money.
Yeah, spend the money, learn the craft, and you'll become a better shooter, and it'll build that your muscle memory that if something happened, you'll go back on your training and rely on your training when the fear kicks in, and you'll be able to, your survivability is a little bit higher.
Absolutely.
Right.
Because once your brain understands what's going on and that you've manipulated the firearm in such a way, whether it's a shotgun, a rifle, or a pistol, you then become second nature. So then your brain can tell the rest of your body, this is what we need to do under stress. And that's the key. We can do it out here in the square range, and we can compete against each other, and we make fun and all that, because we're all going home. But when it's time, or it's a life and death situation, and you really have to do it, you're only going to go back to your training. You're only going back to your least denominator. So if you was having the last couple of weeks some really crappy practice sessions, you're more than likely going to be a crappy putting rounds in places that shouldn't be. So you have to really refine your skill level and be dedicated to it. Dry firing is great, but if you're just snatching a gun out and saying I'm doing it under 1 second, that's great. That's cool. That's good for the gram, but when it comes down to, can you draw that gun out as just as fast and put a round on target effectively? That's where the key comes in. So that's why dry firing is good, but it only gets you so far. You can't dry fire your way into prevailing in a gunfight.
Right. And also, not every gunfight is going to happen in the day, so practice at night too. Mm-hmm. All right.
And not every gunfight is going to happen the way you plan it. It will, unless you are a bank robber or you're the bad guy, you're never going to, you really don't determine when it's going to happen or how it's going to happen.
All right. Thanks again.